Hey everybody, this is a special edition of Step Into the Story, and everyone you're about to hear from are people whose lives were touched and impacted through the legacy of Ray Bentley, my dad. They say that you make a living, you build a life, but what you leave behind is a legacy. And the legacy of Ray Bentley is that he loved people and he loved God. That's our vision statement and our mission statement as a church. And it's the legacy of my father. And it's incredible to hear the outpouring of tributes from people whose lives were so radically impacted and touched by this one man. And so tune in and be blessed by what you hear.
Greetings. I am honored to be asked by Vicky to give this tribute that I've written down to my great friend, Pastor Ray Bentley, a final stepping into the story. It's been 1 week now since Ray has passed over to glory and met his Lord and Savior in person. It still seems a little surreal since I was praying over him last Tuesday, only 4 hours before his passing. In fact, last Friday, only 3 days after Ray left us, I was in my office praying and my phone rang. I looked down at the caller ID and it showed Ray Bentley. Now it's amazing the number of thoughts that can go through your mind in a couple of short rings. With some hesitancy, I answered the phone with a questionable, "Hello?" Immediately blessed to hear Ray's sweet, precious wife, Vicky. She was calling to check on me and see how I was doing. That's just how Ray and Vicky are, full of love, care, and concern for others. Pastor Ray and I usually talked every week, always sharpening iron together and discussing the last day's events and what the Bible teaches about them. As we would always close in praying for each other, Ray would be so honoring to me with such a heart of love. He modeled Christ's likeness. He and Vicky treated my wife, Pam, and I like family, even though we only knew him for a very few years. We truly had kindred spirits. Ray loved his family, and he loved Maranatha Church in being their pastor. He loved Israel and the Jewish people. He studied the Word and knew more about Jewish holidays and feasts than any pastor I knew. His calling as a pastor was truly anointed of the Lord. You know, as I struggled to understand about Ray's passing, I received this word from the Lord, Isaiah 57:1. And it says this, "Good people pass away. The godly often die before their time. But no one seems to care or wonder why. No one seems to understand that God is protecting them from the evil to come." This word has made Ray's passing so much easier. You see, God's ways are higher than mine, and I trust in God's sovereignty. I want to close with this. In my study of the scriptures, I have found that there are 5 crowns available to born-again believers. Depending on the works you do here on earth, depends on how many of these you receive at the Bema Seat of Christ. These crowns will be used one day to lay before the throne and worship God. It is my belief that Pastor Ray Bentley will inherit all 5 of these crowns. And I'm sure that he has heard these words from his Savior, "Well done, Ray Bentley, good and faithful servant." And from me, Ray, I love you, and I will see you very soon. God bless, and Maranatha.
Aloha. Well, first I want to just say that I'm so honored to be able to be doing this tribute for Pastor Ray, and I just want to share with you very briefly about how God has used Pastor Ray in my life over the years. It was actually back in the 80s, and I just fell in love with him and his love for Israel and his love for Bible prophecy, and God just really used him in my life over the years as a young believer, long before I was ever in the ministry, and certainly the pastorate. Well, when I started my first church in Idaho, I was able then to attend the senior pastors conferences in Murrieta, California, and I made it a point, it was kind of a bucket list thing, to meet Ray. And so at lunch, I noticed that his table where he was sitting had a chair next to it that nobody was sitting in. So I got up the gumption and the guts to go over and introduce myself to him and just kind of thank him and tell him how much God had used him in my life. And now I was in the ministry and was a pastor. And so, I mean, it was like we were almost instantly best friends. And from that point on, this was some 20 plus years ago. And so we kind of stayed in touch. And then 2017, my second-born son, Levi, started going to California State University, San Marcos, just 15 minutes away from Maranatha Chapel. So I took him to Maranatha Chapel with a Christian friend of his by the name of Elijah. And I told Levi that this was the church. And I was just so excited. And of course, my son doesn't want to, you know, be known as the pastor's son. And I reassured him that, hey, it's okay. We can, you know, be under the radar. And I'm pretty sure Pastor Ray's not going to remember me. I mean, it's been a while. And so we walked in, and oh my goodness, the people were so welcoming and loving and embracing. And sure enough, somebody recognized me. And my son was like, no way. And they went and got Pastor Ray. And Ray comes up and he's like, no way, JD. And so much for staying under the radar. So it was amazing. And so I introduced him to my son Levi and his Christian friend, whose name was Elijah. And Ray said something like, if you had named your son Moses, we could have had the Mount of Transfiguration right here. And so we talked and prayed together. And then we go into the sanctuary. The worship had already started. And I did not know Ray was going to do this, but he just, before the teaching, mentioned that they had a special guest there, and he had me stand. And it was so embarrassing, and so embarrassing for my son Levi, of course, but it was so good, and the worship was just amazing, and the teaching was, of course, off the charts. But that's just who and how Ray was. And after that, we stayed in contact and talked back and forth. We actually had scheduled for Pastor Ray and Vicky to come here, and Pastor Ray was going to speak. And this was actually in January of 2020, and then last minute it had to be canceled. We tried to reschedule, then of course everything went crazy from that point on. You know, as I have really thought about Ray going home to be with the Lord has sort of reminded me that even if he could, he would not want to come back here now that he's absent from the body and present with the Lord. He wants for us to go up there and meet him in the air when that trumpet sounds. And to that I say, Maranatha, come Lord Jesus. God bless you, Maranatha Chapel. Thank you for sharing Ray with us. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen and aloha.
Hi, Pastor Skip Heitzig here, and it's my privilege to in some way honor a great servant of God, Ray Bentley. Ray was a friend, and Ray was part of what I would call a band of brothers that was around Chuck Smith in the earlier days of that movement. Charles Haddon Spurgeon once said, a good character is the best tombstone. And if that is true, then Ray is a pretty awesome tombstone because he leaves an incredible legacy. Ray Bentley was an encourager. When I first moved to California for a couple of years to help Pastor Chuck Smith out, this is several years back, one of the first people that called was Ray Bentley. And he called to encourage me and to just say he was there for me. Then we shared a conference in Jerusalem several years later with Joel Rosenberg called the Epicenter Conference. And I think it was during that time when our group from our church was there and some from Maranatha were there. We were both together at the Pool of Bethesda. He didn't know I was there yet. He was teaching the church group at the Pool of Bethesda on John chapter 5. And I snuck up behind Ray, told his church to shh, don't say anything. And I scared him. And Ray took it in stride and we had a good laugh. But he was always generous that way. Ray was a godly man. Ray loved what God loves. Ray loved the church. Ray loved his family. Ray loved God's word. And Ray loved the nation of Israel. That marked his ministry all the way through. Ray was a faithful servant of Christ and the church, and he will receive a faithful man's reward. Understand that Ray has already heard from the lips of Jesus the sentence, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your Lord." We know that, and we celebrate that today. There's a tribe of American Indians who once said, "When you were born, you cried, and the world rejoiced. Live your life in such a way that when you die, the world cries, and you rejoice." That's where we are today. Ray is rejoicing. We are mourning. We're mourning Ray because he made a great impact on so many of our lives. But listen, if all we do is speak about how great Ray Bentley was, we've missed the whole point of his life. Ray was a great man because he believed Jesus to be a great Savior. And you need to know that Jesus has the last word in death. He welcomes Ray into his presence. He is in the fullness of joy. And all of the service, all of the love, all of the sacrifice, all of the work that Ray produced was prompted and motivated by the love that Jesus had for him. Let me close just by saying the very last text that I got from Ray was a couple of weeks ago. And he ended by saying, "Blessings and prayers for you and your family, Skip, signed Ray." And he gave a couple of sweet emojis like, "I'm praying for you," and a smiley face and a heart. But that's the kind of person Ray was, an encourager to the end. And so I want to say to Vicky, to Ray and Vicky's children and grandchildren and church family, God bless you and God comfort you during this time. Thank you.
We're already missing Ray. Ray was such a presence. He was always so happy, and he had this way of making you feel so great just that you were alive and that you were in his presence. Wonderful love of Jesus that just radiated out of him. And of course, you can't talk about Ray without talking about his love for Israel, right? And I just think about how both Ray and my dad just loved Israel and how right now they're in New Jerusalem together and they must be having the greatest time because both of them love to meet people and have new adventures. So I'm sure that they are just loving it. It's just us who are missing him so desperately.
Yeah, absolutely. We just loved Ray so much. Some of the wonderful memories that I will cherish are times that I was with Ray. We traveled a lot. We did a lot of great things, a lot of fun things together. And but the thing, you know, that all of us know about Ray was his passion for Jesus, his passion for the coming again of Jesus. I think my last conversation with Ray was that he was telling me absolutely that Jesus is coming really soon. So that was, you know, his heart was there. And none of us ever would have expected that Jesus would come in that way for Ray, but he did. And so our hearts go out to Vicky and to the family. And we love you guys, but we know Ray is, he's where he always wanted to be. Yeah. And so we're thankful that he's there and that one day we'll all be together again. again. So God bless.
Hi, this is Joel Rosenberg in Jerusalem. And I just want to say how much I am praying for you all at Maranatha and how grieved I am about the passing of my friend Ray Bentley. I'm not grieving as a person without hope. I know beyond the shadow of a doubt that Ray is in heaven and couldn't be happier. I know Ray's faith, and I loved that man. We built a friendship that it was entirely built on our love of Christ, our love of the Word of God, our passion about Bible prophecy, and our love for Israel. And not just Israel, but Israel's neighbors as well. Ray was the one who called me up one day. I was at my son Jonah's soccer practice, and he called me up and he said, "Hey, you got a minute?" I said, "Sure." He goes, "We have to do an Epicenter conference in Jerusalem teaching through the entire book of Joel." I said, "What?" And he just talked about how excited he was at reading through the book of Joel, that it was both a wake-up call to the church today and to the world and certainly to Israel, that it was a trumpet call that the Lord is coming back and we have to be ready for that. And it was a warning of judgment to the nations, to nations that turn against Israel, that try to divide the land of Israel. He was so excited. He'd studied the book of Joel so carefully. It is my favorite book of the Bible, not just because of the name. So it didn't take long to persuade me. And sure enough, Ray and Ann Graham Lotz and I held that Epicenter conference. And I just loved his passion. I said, "Hey, Ray, have you ever been to Iraq?" He said, "No." I said, "We're going to do a Joshua Fund, that's our nonprofit ministry. We're going to do a Joshua Fund pastor's retreat for Iraqi pastors. I've been invited to bring a team. Would you come and be part of that?" And he did that. We even went to Nineveh, the province of Nineveh, and specifically the town of Al-Kash. Al-Kash is where the Hebrew prophet Nahum was from and where he's buried. We actually went to the tomb. So whether it was Israel, whether it was Iraq, whether it was coming to preach at Maranatha or come just to visit Ray and Vicky and the kids, not so little anymore, fully grown, I just always loved the time that I had with Ray. I remember we had the opportunity to lead a former Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps officer to Christ and disciple him, and we baptized him together in Ray and Vicky's backyard pool. He had a passion for Christ and the gospel and the word and Israel and Israel's neighbors and even Israel's enemies. And that's why I love him. And he always encouraged me, and I miss him, and I'm praying for you all for comfort, and I can't wait for the day that we're all together again in the presence of Christ. And until then, I say as he would, Maranatha.
Hello, this is Chris Mitchell from CBN News in Jerusalem. It's my honor to join you, Vicky, the Bentley family, the Maranatha family, and people around the world who knew and loved Pastor Ray. Rarely have I met a man so in love with his family, his church, and his Jesus. He exemplified a man who loved God with all his heart and his neighbor as himself. His love of Jesus was infectious. He loved prophecy and the prophetic story we see unfolding in the world today. And I loved how he would bubble over with excitement when he shared another discovery or another insight into the return of Jesus. He loved people. I don't think I'll ever forget how he treated and loved my daughter Kathleen and her then boyfriend, now husband Jay, when we all visited Maranatha Chapel. Kathleen described how incredibly sweet and kind he was to them. And I know that testimony has been multiplied thousands of times throughout Ray's life. Pastor Ray, sweet, kind, gentle, wise, infectious, lover of God and people. A lover of two, of Israel, who blessed the Jewish people practically and spiritually and inherited the promise of Genesis 12:3, that those who bless Israel will be blessed. And perhaps we can honor and remember Ray most by doing what he encouraged us all to do. Step into the story. Put your popcorn down and get into the field. Do what God has called you to do as part of his end time story. But Ray is still part of the story. I imagine he still cannot contain himself when he, along with the other saints, are anticipating and preparing for the return of Jesus. And while the grief of his loss is sometimes overwhelming, the comfort we all have is that Ray is more alive than ever, still part of the story, and looking forward to greeting us when he comes back with the host of heaven and the Ancient of Days to here in Jerusalem, or when the Lord himself calls us home. Father, we just thank you so much for Pastor Ray, what he meant to each and every one of us, to Vicky, to his family, his children, his grandchildren, to the Maranatha family, and the thousands and thousands of people that he touched around the world, and how he touched people here in Israel itself and in Jerusalem. Lord, I pray your comfort upon Vicky and the family and the Maranatha family and all those who mourn his passing, but celebrate his return to you and his eternal home and his eternal reward. So, Father, I just pray that his legacy would continue in so many ways as we all step into the story and prepare for your coming. And we ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless from Jerusalem and Maranatha, and step into the story.
In John chapter 11, when Lazarus died, Jesus was speaking to his sister Martha, and he told her if she would believe, she would see the glory of God. And I know that Jesus believed. He knew he was going to see the glory because he knew he was going to raise Lazarus from the dead. But when he went to the tomb, Jesus wept. So, beloved Vicky and Annie, Daniel and Jill, precious grandchildren, your tears are on his face and on mine and on ours. We weep with you, and we know the glory is coming, but we still weep. Ray Bentley was my pastor. He took me into the fellowship of Maranatha Chapel in an official capacity some time ago, and every 2 weeks or so he would call me, ask how I was doing, pray over me. His prayers were like the balm of Gilead. They just seemed to heal me on the inside. And I told him that I hadn't been shepherded by a pastor like that since I was a little girl. He was very precious to me, and his shepherding extended to my own children and to my grandchildren. He would call them, counsel them, pray over them. And now Ray is gone. So I ask why. And Vicky shared with me a verse from Isaiah chapter 57, verse 1. And as soon as she read it to me, I heard the Spirit whispering, answering that question. And this is what Isaiah 57, verse 1 says. The righteous perish, and no one ponders it in his heart. Devout men are taken away, and no one understands that the righteous are taken away to be spared from evil. And as I've pondered Ray's death, and I know you know that he was taken so quickly. One moment he was talking to Annie, and the next moment he was in heaven talking to Jesus. And as I've pondered his death, and I know he's been taken out of this evil, wicked world in which we're living, but could it be there's something more? And this is what's come to me. This is what the Spirit has whispered to me, that Ray's life, his ministry, his writing, his teaching, his preaching, his podcasts and videos were all wrapped up in prophecy. And could it be that his death also is a prophetic sign? Could it be that Jesus is giving a sign to you and me that he's coming, and he's going to come quickly, and he's going to deliver us from this evil world in which we're living? So I believe the message from Ray Bentley's homegoing is this: Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. And for you and me, as church members, as well as followers of Jesus worldwide, it's time for us to wake up, to clean up, to share the gospel and get ready to meet Jesus and Ray in the air. Maranatha.
30 years ago, Ray and I became friends in a bit of an unusual way. For me, it was more of a divine appointment. For Ray, well, maybe it was more of a divine interruption. Upon moving to San Diego, the first thing I began looking for was a home church. The Sunday our family found Maranatha Chapel, I knew our search was over. When I heard Ray speak, there was such an anointing over his words as he made God's word come alive with incredible enthusiasm and simplicity. It was evident to me that Ray had a very deep walk with God and a passion for his word. The following week, I made an appointment with Ray's executive assistant to meet him. Surprisingly, Ray made time to see somebody that he'd really never even met before. I told Ray at our first meeting that I thought we were going to be good friends. Ray and I began meeting every Tuesday at 7 a.m. for the next 5 years until our family finally moved to Dallas to expand our ministry's outreach. Over my 25-year relationship with Ray, I never saw him stop falling in love with his passion for God and for his word. God chose Ray to be a prophetic voice of the times and season in which we live. He sounded the alarm that came through his life, his sermons, books, radio broadcasts that will continue to go around the world today. So Ray has now joined the cloud of witnesses that are saying to all of us that are still here, don't give up. Don't drop the baton. Don't quit. Keep showing up. Ray didn't crawl over the finish line with burnout and fatigue. He finished with a sprint. His secret to finishing strong can be found in his secret time with God each day, every day. It was out of his love for God that he loved me and the world around him. I will miss you, Ray. My life has been so enriched beyond measure because I was able to call you one of life's loyal friends.
This is my shofar.
This seventh month of the biblical calendar event occurred on the evening of Monday, September 6th, 2021.
On the count of three. Okay, Jericho people, you ready? We're gonna knock the walls of Jericho down. And children, we need you. I am giving you permission to make noise. As loud as you can. Okay, ready? One, two, three.
Many Hebrew scholars and Bible historians agree with Ray that this celebration described by Moses in Leviticus, which includes the blowing of trumpets, is actually fulfilled in 1 Thessalonians. This verse comforts Christians like us who have lost fellow believers, saying that the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout and the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and they that are dead shall rise first, and they which are alive and remain shall be caught up. You know, those scriptures are the very same event. Now, I'm going to conclude with the specific shofar blast, which Jewish scholars believe to be the Leviticus Feast of Trumpets sound. And as I do, consider when it is actually fulfilled, it will also completely fulfill what Ray calls stepping into the story. Here we go. See you really soon, Ray Bentley.
Hello, Maranatha family. This is Pastor Steve from Global Catalytic Ministries. On behalf of everyone here at GCM and the Underground Church, we wanted to send a heartfelt message to say thank you. Pastor Ray was such an incredible impact. He helped serve the Underground Church in ways that will continue to go on for generations. and his heart, his generosity, his wisdom, his fatherly anointing is something that we will continue to carry with us in our hearts. And so we wanted to let you know that from the Underground Church that we are praying with you guys. We're standing with you guys. Pastor Ray will be greatly missed, but his legacy, his impact will continue on in some of the most difficult to reach places in the Middle East. So thank you. We love you. We're praying for the family. God bless.
How you doing? I'm Miles McPherson, pastor of the Rock Church here in San Diego, and Ray Bentley's friend. In 1984, right after I received Christ, I started going to Horizon Christian Fellowship. And I remember getting there, hearing about a guy who had just left to start a church named Ray Bentley. And I didn't meet Ray for many years, but I kept hearing about him and his church growing. Went to Wangenheim, went to then bought land in Penasquitas. And by that time I had met him, but didn't know him really well back then, but I kept hearing about what God was doing through his life. And then I heard that he bought land in Forest Ranch, I don't know, 100 acres or whatever it was, which seemed at the time like he went to Texas because there was nothing out there. And look at what God has done. It's just amazing. But over the years, we did grow to be very close. I consider him like a big brother to me. He was a father figure to my daughter. We got together and spoke about some of the hard things she was going through, and she said he was like a father figure to her. As we all know, Ray was kind. He was very gentle, very calming, always was a very good listener. But one funny story, I wrote a book called The Third Option, Hope for a Racially Divided Nation, and after he read it, we had a lot of conversations about race. And in that book, I talk about white being a color, how we always talk about people being colored and white people, but in reality, we're all colored. And Ray was excited that he was colored. And there were like 10 conversations in a row. He kept saying, I'm so excited that I'm a colored person. Ray had a sense of humor. But Ray and I met 5 weeks ago, and we talked about getting together regularly to pray. And unfortunately, that did not happen. Vicky, we're praying for you. Maranatha, we're praying for you. We love y'all. And we know that God is going to support you, uphold you, sustain you. You're going to thrive in only a way God can do. So thank you, Ray, for your life. Thank you for your commitment. Thank you for being a role model to all of us. God bless you.
Shalom. Pastor Mark Biltz here of El Shaddai Ministries. To Vicky and all of the family, I just want you to know that my wife, Vicky, her heart and my heart so go out to all of you of the family, as well as all of you at Maranatha Chapel. I just want you to know that your family, Vicky and Ray, you have been such a blessing to my Vicky and I, you know, even all the way back from when the relationship first started, back in 2008, it's hard to believe when you asked us to come out. It was such a blessing to stay with you guys at your house. I just want you to know, Vicky, that you and Ray have been such a blessing and so welcoming to Vicky and I. And I love the relationship that we've been able to maintain. I know Pastor Ray and I, over the years, have been in constant communication, even as recently as just a couple of weeks ago when he went down to Texas to take a look at the red heifer. I was invited to go with him, but my schedule just wouldn't allow it. And this has come as such a shock to all of us. But you need to know that our hearts are really with you guys. And if there's anything we can do, we just love you guys. We really do. And we'd love to do it. I just want to leave with you a word from the Lord, a Bible verse that has such meaning to me. And I know it will to you as well, Vicky. We know that God has all numbered our days. But I want to leave you with this. In Psalms 116 and verse 15. You're very familiar with the verse. It says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his holy ones. But I wanted to say that the English word precious really is not the best translation. The word precious is better translated as the word costly, referring to the price of precious jewels. So Ray was not only precious in God's sight, we need to realize his life was costly, like a precious jewel. And Ray's absence from this earth is costly to the kingdom of God because of all the phenomenal blessings that he and you have done all over the world. In Ray's case, I believe it was very costly. Ray was a ray of light and all of his abundant joy, not only for the Lord, but he also brought so much joy to so many. One other thing I want to bring out, and that is that as far as Ray being compared to a precious jewel in Hebrew and his life was costly, there are also different words for hiding. One Hebrew word for our word hidden implies buried treasure that's been hidden, that you are definitely coming back for. Well, right now, I believe that Ray is the Lord's buried treasure that he is definitely coming back for. And I honestly believe that he's coming back for him and all of us very soon. The Bible says that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, nor has it ever even entered into our hearts all the things that God has prepared for those who love him. Well, I believe right now Ray is definitely getting an eyeful and an earful. We just love him. And I'm just so grateful for the impact that he's had on my life. I know one of the greatest things that impact people is other people. And I just want you to know Ray had a tremendous impact in my life. And I know he truly is right now like that hidden pearl that everything is sold to get that land. And I really believe the Lord's going to be coming back for Ray very soon. Bless you, Vicky. Bless you, Maranatha Chapel. Love you all.
Hey, Maranatha family. We are all very shocked and saddened with the passing of Pastor Ray. He was a spiritual father to us. We got connected through you guys from our Israel trip in 2016. And we are really, really, we have been blessed and has been encouraged by his ministry and even by your love to us. And we just want to know, we just want you to know that we are with you. And we just want to thank you for his life that's been invested in us and our families.
You know, even though our time with Pastor Ray or Papa Ray wasn't long, rather it was short but significant. And spiritual fathers often have a way of making the moments count. And he made every moment count with us. We felt so loved. He showed us the heart of the Father. And he really ushered us into God's prophetic timeline in the little time that we had together. And we miss him so much as well. We know that you must be grieving too. I would just want you to know that the impact that Pastor Ray and Maranatha has made an impact on the other side of the world and even through us to other nations as well.
It is a very important time that we continue Pastor Ray, Papa Ray's legacy. He invited us to step into the blueprint of God's prophecy in the land of Israel. And we continue to carry the same love that Pastor Ray Bentley had carried, the love for the Lord, the love for the lost, and the love for the land of Israel. And we believe and we pledge that we'll continue his legacy till the day we will see Papa Ray face to face and we'll hear those wonderful words of Jesus together with him. Well done, our good and faithful servant. We send our love from Singapore to San Diego. We send our love from 316 family to our family in Maranatha. God bless you. Let's continue to be strong in the Lord.
I'm David Jeremiah from the Shadow Mountain Community Church in El Cajon. Cannot tell you how saddened and shocked I was when I heard of the homegoing of Ray Bentley. It seems like over these last months, we've lost more than a share of good men who have filled the pulpits of our land with the teaching of the gospel and the encouragement of the Holy Spirit. I did not know Ray really well. We were two busy pastors doing our thing, him in the North County, I was in the East County. But I remember him from several occasions where we were together, and especially the time that I came to Maranatha to preach, and the joy that that was for me to meet him and Vicky and the family. And I loved him. I know that that's a simple thing to say. It's true for all of us who knew him. He was just hard not to love. And his going to heaven at this time is, well, it just leaves a huge hole in our hearts. And we wonder why, but we know God is a God who does all things well, so we don't question it. But we reflect on a man who lived his life well, who made a difference, whose influence touched many. I'm here at Turning Point doing this video, and there are people here that work here, that go to that church, who have been blessed so much by his life and his ministry. And I want to just say thank you to Ray and to all of you who knew him and helped him do the work that he did. He will be greatly missed, but he will also be greatly loved and appreciated. I'm going to take the liberty for just a moment to share with you something that I just learned a few months ago that has been such a great encouragement to me when we face moments like this. There are two times when we are involved with either the entry or the exit of this earth. At birth, we come to this earth. At death, we leave this earth. Both of them involve pain. But a friend of mine explained it to me this way, and it's been so helpful to me, and I hope it will bring comfort to your hearts. In birth, we start out with the mother experiencing pain that is, first of all, intense, and then more intense, and then closer together and closer together. And then, as my friend said, the mom goes through the birth process, which he called the circle of fire. I'm sure there are many women who would agree with that. And then the pains that went before are diminished and go away. That's how we enter the earth. That's how we enter into life, through the pain of birth. But death is exactly the opposite. We go through the circle of fire first. We experience all the pain of that without any diminishing. And then little by little, that pain gets a little less intense and the pain's a little further away until the process of birth is reversed in the process of death. And God is with us in all of it. He has promised never to leave us nor forsake us. Death means to be separated. And if you don't know Jesus Christ, that's a terrible thought, because if you die without him, you'll be separated from God forever and ever. But death for the Christian is only the separation of his soul from his body, and it doesn't even last forever, only till that moment when the resurrection comes and we'll be caught up to be with the Lord. And the Bible says, and so shall we ever be with him. The hope that we have, the hope that Ray Bentley preached, that this church believes, is the hope that will sustain us as we go forward. We don't know each other well. Our churches are quite a ways away, but I promise you there are many people at Shadow Mountain praying for all of you. We love you. We hope that in the days ahead you will see the hand of God in ways that will be way beyond anything you anticipated. He's a God of love, and he will never stop loving you.
I met Pastor Ray years ago through my friend and brother, Robert Booth. Rob had talked to Pastor Ray about Christian Arabs living in Nazareth, and I had the opportunity to meet with Pastor Ray in his office at the church. One of the first things he told me in that meeting was that he wanted to learn more about the Christian Arabs living in the Holy Land, as until then, he did not know much about us. That is how the relationship between Maranatha Chapel and the Nazareth Baptist School got started. We are saddened about the passing of Pastor Ray, but are also comforted in knowing that even though he's absent from the body, he is present with the Lord, celebrating and receiving his crown. His family are in our prayers, as are Pastor Danny and the rest of the congregation of Maranatha Chapel.
Ray was keen to educate his congregation about Arab Christians in general through the prism of us in Nazareth. As a result, a large number of activities were initiated during all these years, including visits of different groups in both San Diego and Nazareth. God has worked through youth groups and pilgrimage groups visiting Nazareth, ministering and worshiping with us in the local congregation and in summer camps. It also included generous donations for the ministry of the school by the Nehemiah Fund. Above all the programs through the years and the blessed partnership, we were blessed really by the kindness, care, and generosity of Pastor Ray. We pray that our friend, Pastor Danny, will continue the legacy.
Hi, my name is Bill Koenig. I had the blessing of meeting Ray Bentley at Calvary Chapel, Fort Lauderdale in April 2001. We were there for Benjamin Netanyahu's address to that very large church. And then my last visit with Brother Ray was at a ranch west of Dallas on December 20th, as we were watching the Israeli rabbis investigate possible red heifer candidates, which ended up being 18. Ray and I had a mutual love of Israel and prophecy, and especially Jesus. I saw Ray many times over the years at the NRB convention in Los Angeles, in Jerusalem, at Jerusalem Prayer Breakfast, at the Convergence Conference there at your church in 2017. Ray and Vicky visited our home in Virginia in 2019 and our wonderful dinner we had in Tucson on March 2020. Ray was such a great encourager and prayer support during Claudia's 8.5 years of metastatic breast cancer. Vicky was there for us too. I called Ray minutes after my dear wife passed into God's glory, and Ray was there for me then and many other times over the past couple months. I told Ray many times there is no greater honor and privilege than to be a pastor, and no greater reward than to do it right. Ray did it right. Also, Ray's amazing Step Into the Story series took Ray's normal joy to a whole different level. I told my wife Claudia last summer, this could be one of the best signs that Jesus is coming real soon, is Ray's joy. It was off the chart, as you all have seen during this series. Ray is home now, and thank God for a man that touched many of our lives, a true friend. I'm hopeful and prayerful that we will be with Jesus, Ray and my wife Claudia, soon. I think Revelation 21:4 is a great scripture for this moment. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Maranatha.
I love Pastor Ray Bentley. I felt so special that he called me his best friend. I knew he was besties with everybody, but it didn't take away anything because there was enough of Ray to go around.
This is like a huge magic key to the kingdom.
Ray made me feel significant, loved, and appreciated, and I watched him make everybody he met feel the same way. Ray had the purest pastoral gift I'd ever experienced, and I know a lot of pastors. Ray loved Americanos because it tasted like it smelled, and he loved the British luxury car Bentley because it was named after him. Interestingly, his parents named him Rayburn, but everyone called him Ray. He was a ray of light, a vector pointing to Jesus and showing us the way. The name Ray means counsel protector, and Ray took it serious. He took our side against the wilds of the devil, and he gave us fantastic counsel. If you knew Ray, you knew his favorite topic was the end times. He loved the end times so much because he knew each of us we're facing the end, whether corporately or personally. Ray dedicated his life to preparing us to meet Jesus. I'm confident that the Lord will fulfill his word in Haggai 2:9. The glory of this present house will be greater than the glory of the former house, says the Lord, because he and Vicky put the love of God in their children and prepared them for ministry. I look forward to witnessing the fulfillment of Haggai 2:9. As Daniel takes the leadership of Maranatha. Would you join me in loving Ray and supporting the anointing on his son, Pastor Daniel, as he leads Maranatha to greater glory? Ray ran his race. He fulfilled his call. And in doing so, he gave us the same tools to prepare us to meet the Lord. To God be the glory.
And once you get that going and you get them into a relationship with the King of the kingdom, the Lord Jesus Christ, everything else will follow.
Dear Vicky, Bentley family, and Maranatha congregation, Shalom for Marielle. I can't recall the exact time Ron met Pastor Ray or both of us met Vicky, but it doesn't matter because from that moment on, it felt like we knew each other forever. People can ask and people have asked, what does an Israeli Sabra Jew can have in common with a Christian American? The answer is simple, and whoever met Pastor Ray and Ron could feel it. They share the vision and the determination to make the vision a reality. Our good friend Robert Mugriri says, where there's a vision, there's provision. He's right. And I don't mean the financial support, though it helps, but the friendship, the partnership, the walking together a long way, not always easy, but committed and determined. This is what Ron and Ray shared. I know how much Ron loved to talk with Ray, how much he valued his perspective and advice. And I know and remember the times we were all together with our children over dinner, like the family will always be. When I was informed of Ray's passing, I read again his book, Holy Land Key, and felt through the pages Ron and Ray walking and talking together. Thank you, Bruce Johnston and Robert Mugriri, for introducing the Bentleys and the Nachmans and being such good friends. Vicky, losing the love of one's life is hard and painful. But there's something of Ray in each of your children and grandchildren, and I'm sure in every member of Maranatha congregation and all the people you touched. Ray is in us and in our hearts forever. I love you.
Good morning, everyone. When I heard Ray passed away, I struggled with that news. It was unexpected. It was unwelcome. So I took a trip to Egypt, and I went down denial. But then I found myself sitting with a computer to let some words out, and I typed out these words that I entitled, Portraits of Jesus. What pictures go through your mind when you think of Ray Bentley? Do you think of his calm demeanor during the regular crises of life? Do you picture him on a platform serving us a generous helping of the word? Do you think of someone who was just never out of hugs or words or compassion? When I think of Ray, I think of my younger cousin who was so full of life, so full of energy and love. I might first picture his smile, and perhaps here in the back of my mind, his little staccato laughter at my dumb jokes. But it doesn't take me very long in thinking about Ray that I find myself thinking of Jesus. You know those pictures that actually have another picture hidden within them? Sometimes it's the picture which is of a young girl or an old woman, and a caption that asks, which one do you see first? You have the one picture that's obvious and the one picture that's hidden. And once you see the second picture, which always seems to take a little extra effort for me, once you see it, the second picture becomes much more prominent. I think Ray and Jesus were much like that. Ray lived out the presence of Jesus in his life, and to see Ray was eventually to see Jesus. It's pretty safe to say that Ray didn't hide his portrait of Jesus as he lived out a faithful and loving life. The life of love that God has called each of us to was intertwined throughout Ray's life, all throughout his ministry, shared with us in conversations and stories and meals and wherever your life happened to intersect with his. And at each of those points, a portrait of the Jesus that Ray had come to know and love through so many years of faithful service, that portrait was lived into focus before us again and again. He lived out his life as a portrait of Jesus. I think that we are able to picture Jesus better because of the life that Ray lived, a life filled full with faithfulness to the Word, and I mean here both the living Word and the written Word, a faithfulness that he joyfully experienced and proclaimed over the course of his life and ministry. He was a student of the Word, and in that journey he spent countless hours bringing his questions, and perhaps more importantly, his answers back to the Word. He allowed the Word to critique and challenge his own life before he challenged us. Ray was a pastor to so many, and he lived out this title as the true gift that it is. Just look around you today. Look at the faces Ray loved, the shoulders he hugged, the lives he touched. And I am reminded of St. Paul's words from 1 Thessalonians 2:19. For what is our hope, our joy, or the crown in which we will glory in the presence of our Lord Jesus when he comes? Is it not you? You see, Ray took great joy in pointing beyond himself to Jesus. And there are countless stories lived and told of how Pastor Ray made a difference. Henry Nouwen described the life and work of the minister this way: the great vocation of the minister is to continuously make connections between the human story and the divine story. Ray made those connections for us, constantly mining the depths of our lives in order to point us to the Jesus we encounter precisely there, by listening to the love of God which reaches out to us, no matter how far we have run, no matter how adept we are as we try to hide, or even how disinterested we are in God. God's love continues to reach out for us. Ray knew that reaching love of God, and he painted a living portrait of it in his ministry and in his life. Humility, infectious joy, wonderful teacher, faithful servant. Those are just a few of the words lifted from the comments on the church's Facebook announcement after Ray's death. And in the word pictures that have poured in to pay tribute to Ray, we hear over and over of someone that Ray had poured his heart and life into as he pointed them to Jesus. You've perhaps heard the old saying that you are the only Christ that some people will ever see. Well, Ray lived that saying well, even though he left us too soon. Thanks, cuz, for teaching us that God is good all the time, and for being for us a living portrait of Jesus. Blessings.
We woke up here in Yerushalayim in Jerusalem with such sad news to hear the passing of our dearest friend, Ray Bentley. And I want to first of all open up with the blessing of Baruch Dayan Ha'emet. And I want to bless the family from here, from Yerushalayim, from Jerusalem. Hamakom Yenachem Otchem. The Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, shall comfort you within all of the mourners of Jerusalem, of Zion. And I could tell you that Ray has been such a close friend, and what he has done in this world is tremendous. And it will affect not just this generation, but many generations to come. And Ray, just like his name has shined his glory on this world and has done so much, and it's sad for us that he has left us, but we know that he is in a better place and he is close to Hashem. So may we all give you comfort to ourselves. Amen.
Shalom, everybody. I'm Jonathan Kahn, and I'm doing a selfie in the basement of my house. And the first thing I want to do is send my greetings and prayers to Ray's family, and then to Ray's ministry, Maranatha Chapel, and all of you, his friends, and those who've been touched by Ray's life. I'm one of them. The Lord brought us together years ago when Ray reached out to me and wanted me to come to San Diego and minister at Maranatha Chapel, and it was a wonderful time, a wonderful ministry there, live, full of life, and it was such a sweet time to be with Ray that we spoke of the things that God was doing prophetically, end times, Israel, amazing things where God had blown Ray away with amazing encounters, amazing experiences. And Ray was so open and full of passion. And we had stayed in touch through text through the years. But recently, I felt a real burden to reconnect more strongly. And so we did the last few months by text and email, sharing. He had sent me actually a prophetic word, and I was asking him about it. And he was telling me about, he was excited about the red heifer that was discovered, and did I want to go down and see it? And we arranged, he invited me to come back to minister at Maranatha. And we wrote how much we longed to see each other again and really and catch up and talk of the things of God. What always struck me about Ray from the time I first met him to the very our last correspondences, which were very recent, was one, his humility, two, his love for Israel, three, his passion and zeal for the things of God, for the ways of God, for the wonders of God, for the amazingness of God. It was like a childlike wonder. And that's really what it's about. There are people who lose that, and sometimes in leadership or ministry or success, they lose that simplicity of the wonder of God, and he didn't, and nor of for end time prophecy. He was always zealous for the blessed hope. And you know, I regret in one sense that we didn't have that time to be together, but I know we will have that time to be together. And just as you know, Ray has graduated. He has fought the good fight. He ran the race, and he finished with faith and blessing and zeal, with a tremendous legacy from his family and in ministry that has touched countless lives. And he is receiving his reward. He graduated, and he is not just writing about these things of God, of the restoration of the temple. He's in the temple, and he is seeing what he's longed for. And so we know we'll all meet again. Ray lived his life in the Lord well, that the Lord would say, well done, with humility, with grace, with integrity, and with life and that wonder. And so I just want to send a blessing out to you guys of comfort and the Lord's keeping for the family and the ministry. And you know, what is of the Lord never ends. And so the fruit of Ray's life will go on and on and on here and there and when we meet again. So here's the blessing. And I would have done it when Ray was there in his presence, but here's the blessing. Yivrechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha ya'er Adonai panavlecha v'chunecha yisa Adonai panavlecha v'yasem lecha shalom. The Lord bless you all, keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you and pour out his grace upon all of you. The Lord lift up the glory of his countenance, his glory, his light upon you, and the Lord give you shalom, life, fullness, peace, all the blessings of his love, B'Shem Yeshua HaMashiach, in the name of Jesus the Messiah, Or HaOlam, the light of the world, Uchvod Yisrael, the glory of Israel, V'Roeh HaTov, and our good shepherd, in his holy name, amen. God bless you all. Shalom.
Shalom. We bow our heads in mourning over the loss of the great leader, Pastor Ray Bentley. This is a tremendous loss, not only to the family and the community and the church, but also to society at large. My name is Hillel Newman, and I'm the Consul General of Israel, representing the State of Israel to the Pacific Southwest. We stand shoulder to shoulder with the community and share in the grief over this great loss. I have no doubt that the gates of heaven have opened up to embrace Pastor Ray Bentley, for his virtues, for his dedication of a full life to values, and for his love of Zion and Israel. He was a dear friend of the people of Israel. He dedicated time, effort, and even money in support of causes connected to the land of Israel and the people of Israel. We do not forget our friends, and we stand together and share in your grief. We wish condolences to the family, the community, and society. Thank you.
Ray was truly God's friend. He loved the Lord and people, all types of people. He was God's chosen to showcase what it means to be the friend of God. Because of this, there was a certain nobility and grace moving through him. He was that friend to me that was closer than a brother. He gave me my first real job, best man at my wedding, loved me as the Lord shared. A true friend loves without ending and at all times. If you knew Ray, you met the great encourager. He even complimented me by saying I was the Ansel Adams of color on behalf of Israel. Another time, Ray was learning to surf and we went out, huge day. He got cleaned up on a monster outside set. And there he is laying on the beach, and a few hours later I would come in. So, Ray, what was that like? And he smiled, he goes, it was like King Kong grabbing you by the ankles and shaking you around like a rag doll. Always having a positive spin and humor in life. Ray was a romantic and Renaissance man. I could see that in his marriage. One Valentine's Day, he was so focused on showing Vicky the love of his life, his devotion for her. And that mischievous smile, he looked at me and said, Jeff, let's go. And after that trip, I smiled at him and said, that was impressive. You've ruined Valentine's Day now, Ray. For every married man, you understand that crazy love. But you keep this to yourself. Later, I would call him the scholar of love. Another time, we received an invitation to meet with Yitzhak Shamir, and the prime minister walked up to us and smiled, and he said, ah, the young ones. Ray would later share with me, my heart is with these people. Let's create a legacy of love. Ray was prophetic that day, and then very understated what you and your church would go on to do. However, Ray's true devotion and love resides within his marriage to Vicky and their two incredible children, Daniel and Annie, his Iron Man dad, who at 90 does pull-ups every day, and his brother Greg, that shares that contagious, mischievous grin. And behind this love is all of those amazing sermons that were lived out before they were ever preached. He would say, because I love the Lord, I could love my family as I have been loved. One time in college, I read something I had to share with Ray. It was a quote from Paul Tournier. Death is the last of God's mercies. I didn't know that I would be sharing some of those private moments here. But you knew one day God would be merciful to that final walk. What I do know is I do not want to say goodbye. I felt we had more to do here. So I'll share what cowboys say. We never say goodbye, but I will see you later.
There's not very many people in our lives who we can honestly say changed our lives completely. And when we do say that about people, it's usually exaggeration. But with Ray Bentley, there's no exaggeration there for so many of us, myself included. I remember 1996, my dad and mom sat me, my brother Phil, and my sister Jillian down in the living room in Orange County in our little house and said, all right, we're moving to San Diego. Ray called. And my dad came on staff here as worship pastor, and the rest is history. I likely, probably would not have known my wife, or my five kids wouldn't have existed. We wouldn't live in this city at all and had a calling here and a vocation here if it weren't for Ray and Vicky Bentley responding to God's voice in faithfulness to build his church. And thousands of lives have been mobilized for the kingdom due to their direct influence for the kingdom of God, and I honor that. I honor that. I remember sitting in Ray's office in 2016 when my wife and I set out to plant our church. And I asked him, like, what's one thing you would say to your younger self setting out to do this work? And his answer surprised me. It wasn't, you know, something I heard a lot before. I was expecting, you know, preach the word faithfully or make sure you go on dates with your wife all the time, which are all great things, big advocate. But it was different. He said, never underestimate the power all around you in the unseen realm, and that you are a child of light called by God to push back on Satan's dark dominion in the name of Jesus all the time, and never rule out the demonic from the trials of life. So much wisdom. I'm actually getting chills even now thinking about his response to my question. And he lived in God's presence in that way, and he always brought people into God's presence, and now he's there himself. Praise God.
I just wanted to take a minute to share a couple of stories about Pastor Ray. It was back in 2010. We were traveling into Iraq. Joel Rosenberg and the Joshua Fund team, we were going in to minister to the locals there in Kurdistan, Erbil area. And it's a little bit of a funny story. We had taken off from Jordan. We're trying to get to Iraq, but the weather had turned. I don't know, almost maybe a sandstorm, something. It was bad weather. Either way, we couldn't land in Iraq, so we had to turn around and fly back to Jordan. The one thing is, Pastor Ray had fallen asleep on the plane, so he wasn't aware that we had actually had to turn around and fly back to Jordan. So we land in Jordan. They get us off the plane, they put us in a waiting room, and we're sitting there for a little while. And then finally, Pastor Ray comes out with, why won't they let us leave the airport here in Iraq? To when, that's when we all realized, oh, he didn't know that we had actually had to return back to Jordan. So it was a funny moment, and it was one of many great moments we had on that trip as we were able to minister to the local people there in Iraq, to the believers. And the other thing that I wanted to share was from a time, and it's really, really significant in this very moment we're living in. And really, for me personally, it's like a legacy that Pastor Ray left to us. And it was from a time when we were doing an Epicenter conference again with Joel and the team there in Germany. And as we did this Epicenter conference there in Siegen, Pastor Ray shared from Daniel's story, from specifically in chapter 5 of Daniel, when Belshazzar has his big feast. And as you guys know the story, the hand, you know, appears and the writing is on the wall, many, many tekel upharsin, you know, numbered, numbered, way divided. And this was just a signal to this corrupt king that his days were numbered and that God was going to judge him for his behavior, taking the, you know, the cups and all the things from the temple and drinking out of them and worshiping the gods of silver and gold and all. And so, as you know, Pastor Ray communicated the story, something he applied to our lives in this very moment was the fact that you and I, well, actually everyone in that point saw the handwriting on the wall, right? But nobody could interpret it. And what his point to us was, is this: the world right now is seeing what's going on prophetically. And yet many don't have a clue what it means. They don't understand what's happening. Yet you and I, as believers in Jesus Christ, who've been given the scriptures and who have been given understanding to see and understand the word of God and what is coming prophetically, we have the ability to interpret to a lost and dying world the truth of God's word, and we can bring people to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ because we have the interpretation. Like Daniel, he was able to come and shed light in that situation. So too, you and I, as people are looking around wondering what is going on in our world, they see the writing on the wall, but they don't know what it means. You and I have the privilege, really, we have the responsibility to share that truth. And that was something that Pastor Ray shared many years ago that has stuck with me to this very moment every day. I'm thinking about that often. I've shared it many times because it's so powerful in terms of the responsibility and the role we get to play in these last days. Pastor Ray was faithful to do that. I just received actually his books. And you know, that is another way that he's been doing that as well. And it's been a huge blessing to see how he left that legacy as well to all of us, to keep fighting the good fight, to keep running the race, and to finish strong. And so I am just so grateful for Pastor Ray, the encouragement he's been, I know, to so many and to myself included. and how we will miss him greatly, but we look forward to seeing him soon because we're looking forward to our, you know, Savior's soon return. Bless you all. Thank you so much for giving me that chance to share.
We woke up here in Yerushalayim in Jerusalem with such sad news to hear the passing of our dearest friend, Ray Bentley. And I want to first of all open up with the blessing of Baruch Dayan Ha'emet. And I want to bless the family from here, from Yerushalayim, from Jerusalem. Hamakom Yenachem Otchem. The Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, shall comfort you within all of the mourners of Jerusalem, of Zion. And I could tell you that Ray has been such a close friend, and what he has done in this world is tremendous. And it will affect not just this generation, but many generations to come. And Ray, just like his name has shined his glory on this world and has done so much, and it's sad for us that he has left us, but we know that he's in a better place and he is close to Hashem. So may we all give you comfort to ourselves. Amen.
So may the Lord bless you. May the Lord put a fire within your spirit and within your soul. May you pray with fervency and with passion. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And pray that our generation will be awake and alive, and that we will live with a revival fire within us. Let this be the day of great awakening. Let it be the day of revival. Let it be the day of restoration. May the Lord bless you. And man, let's just keep praying. Let's keep sharing. Let's keep stepping into the story, because the Lord is coming soon. Maranatha, I love you. God bless you. And we'll see you soon.